Lo que pasó fue que... que destruyeron el skatepark y nosotros, pues nos van a hacer un skatepark. Y realmente no pasó eso. No se iba a hacer el skatepark.
Pues no sé, porque los años pasados decían que sí lo iban a hacer, pero no, nunca se hizo.
And what I'm hearing right now, it just, it seems like it's not going to happen. And it seems like it's going to be another 3 years of the same thing over and over. And remember, I started this back in 2008 with a 3-year government, and that's how the governments are here in municipalities in Mexico. And when the government ends and they change the next one, you have to start all over again, unfortunately. And this is the third government, and it seems like it's just not going to happen again. And that is so frustrating for me to stay focused and continue going on. That's where I'm at right now.
Life is exactly, it's not a lot like skateboarding. It's exactly like skateboarding. What they do is they fall and they get back up.
Y aún en mi tabla de X flojos por la calle, y no hay quien calle. Es un desmadre, yo feliz patinando, no me meto con nadie en cambio. Todo el mundo jode, jode con su bla bla bla, con su mugre pseudocrítica constructiva, con su vida toda linda que a mí no me va. Su mundito color rosa, lo superficial. ¿Cuántas veces me he metido contigo? Dime, ¿cuántas veces te he ofendido? Dime, es comportamiento de amigos, que tu vida sea un desmadre y te la cobres conmigo. Basta, me subiré a mi skateboard a olvidarlo todo, a rolar por ahí, a borrar tu odio. Los que no creen en mí, no soy moneda de oro, y los que siguen allí son mi gran tesoro.
Ando rolando en mi rueda, voy volando.
No hay nadie aquí, solo mi tabla y yo.
Ando rolando en mi rueda, voy volando.
Sigo así, esto nunca cambió.
Ando rolando en mi rueda, voy volando.
Me lleva el viento, viviendo a mi manera.
Ando rolando en mi rueda, voy volando.
Corazón de concreto y un alma de madera.
So I was gonna say, what we do with this here is we set it up already as coping on both sides, and then we'll use that ramp and set up that ramp so they can ramp off of it and do, like, you know, 5-0, 50-50s, K-grind, whatever, Smith, Feebles. I grew up here. And it was a pretty simple life. Rocky Point was fairly small back then. My mother brought me to the U.S. when I was a little kid. But throughout the summer, I would come here. Rocky Point grew from fishing town. About the late 90s, all of a sudden, skyscrapers and resorts started popping up right on the beach. It totally changed Rocky Point. There was this group of kids when I used to work for the city of Phoenix. I would come to the community center and skateboard. And my supervisors were telling them, get out of here, kids. Your guys are making a mess. You're destroying everything. You guys are a pain in the butt. Get out of here, or we're calling the cops, or something to that effect. And then I'm like, why are we telling kids to leave a community center? That doesn't make sense. So I started organizing those kids, and before you knew it, we were a little club. And I thought, this is cool. You know, I want to do more of this.
Probably will follow you. So just go about your business. Yeah. fond of mine.
Armando, ahí anda, mira. Bien entrado usted.
The company started back in 2008 when I no longer worked for Parks and Rec, and now I had that extra time to focus on something like that.
And these are the ones that we're gonna give the kids for free. I've been using these guys since day one to do the prints on the t-shirts. Mm-hmm. He does a decent job and it's pretty cheap. It's like $5 for a printed shirt.
As I was just working details out in my head, you know, I started noticing that there was skateboarding in Rocky Point too. Not a lot, just a few kids here and there. And I started approaching some of these kids, which was kind of weird at first, you know, because I didn't know them. In a weird way, I was naturally market researching. And I figured out that it was little to no support down here. And that's when I decided to choose Rocky Point.
I mean, I think the parks are key to building skateboard scenes, and the reason that is that it's a safe place the kids can go every single day. And just like anything, you're trying to, if you're honing your skills at anything, if you can't skate somewhere consistently, then how do you hone those skills, and how can you progress?
Infrastructure, invest in skate parks and stuff like that, that's why the kids are so good in the U.S. You know, it's not because I think U.S. kids are better. Because I've met so many kids here now that if the kids here were in the U.S., they would totally kill everybody. It has to be this year. And if it's not this year, then it's not gonna happen. I've been working on this project for 5 years.
What do you do if it doesn't go through?
What I do if it doesn't go through, I think, is, even though it'd be difficult, is wait for the next administration to come in and start it all over with them. You can't give up because it's not for you, it's for the community, and it's the right thing to do.
Ah, huevo. Vamos.
The idea always in the back of my head was to bridge the gap and that imaginary distance between the United States and Mexico.
Somos cinco, mis cuatro hijos, una niña, tres niños y yo. Cuando nosotros nos divorciamos, él tenía como 5 años. Y prácticamente sí me ha tocado el desarrollo de ellos, como ya adolescentes, me tocó vivir sola.
Me levanto, voy a la escuela, regreso a mi casa, como, luego me voy a patinar y me regreso otra vez a la casa. siempre he patinado así sin skatepark. Siempre he avanzado pues nomás en la calle o en el malecón con lo que tenemos.
Although back then, it was skateboarding really good, and he had always torn up shoes, really torn up shoes. A very inadequate skateboard. I mean, it wasn't even round anymore, it was square. Different set of trucks, four different types of wheels. And I would see that and I would really appreciate that this kid is a skateboarder.
Pues con llegar a ser amateur y patinar por alguna compañía grande y estar tan siquiera manteniéndome de eso para poder vivir a gusto y pues estar patinando hasta que ya no pueda.
The Mexican people really have a strong, strong passion for skating. If you're that good, then your opportunity is everywhere, you know. But you know, it's really competitive in the United States to turn pro and to make that happen, make those dreams come true. And to ride for a respectable brand that most people would be passionate about, it's very difficult to make that whole transition happen when you're from, you know, a faraway place.
Mi mamá, porque pues, nos apoya mucho y trabaja mucho pues, para que estemos bien. Y fuera de todo lo del deporte y de todo lo demás, la persona que mejor conozco y es la persona que más admiro.
I've been sponsoring Aldo for a little bit over a year. He didn't have much going on and I invited him, said, come over to our place for New Year's. He said, really? And I'm like, yeah. And then when New Year's came, you know, we all gave each other a New Year's hug and I pulled him to the side and then I offered him sponsorship. And he went crazy. It was like, wow, really?
Yo creo mucho en Braulio. Creo mucho en el trabajo que él hace. De hecho, es la única persona a la que le he confiado a mis hijos, a mi hijo. Totalmente él es influencia para mí. Y como buena influencia, yo le he permitido lo que sea querido. He's stay my son. He's stay my family. Sorry. Es que él, estoy llorando. Él me ha ayudado mucho, él me ha apoyado. He supported me too much. I'm so so glad. Too much.
Christian, I sponsored him on his birthday. I got a ATMC skateboard and I had the whole crew sign it. And I said, do you want to be part of the team?
Mi papá me estaba enviando dinero y mi mamá también, pero no se pudieron seguir las cosas con la escuela porque mi papá no me siguió dando dinero. Por eso me moví y estoy estudiando en línea. Mi mamá pensaba que, ¿quién es Braulio? ¿Quién es esa persona? ¿Por qué te está ayudando? ¿Por qué está haciendo eso? Pues no cualquiera va a tu casa y vamos a patinar, vamos a tratar de hacer algo. Y por eso se quedaba mi mamá, no tenía la confianza, pero él fue cambiando eso y ahora me ha apoyado mucho.
Es diferente como otros sponsors, como los otros patrocinios nomás te dan, por ejemplo, una tabla al mes y esto no te... Si hay un concurso, no te llevan, no te ayudan con viaje, inscripción ni nada, eso nomás está en una tabla. Y pues Braulio pues nos da todo.
Where Aldo's more of a natural good skater, Christian is more of a hardcore, I'm gonna skate my butt off every day to get to my goal. And even though it's a different set of mind, it's the same type of hunger. And I think he has just as much probability of becoming something just as Aldo. Every kid wants to be pro, but then again, every kid knows that it's something very difficult to attain.
Pues, no sé, con el que sea, con mis amigos, me gusta más.
Ah, ¿estabas jugando? ¿Eh? ¿Estabas jugando?
No, tú y yo que estábamos rolándolo. Y era como las 12 y 40.
¿Te acuerdas de la operación? ¡A la virgen! ¡Oye, oye esta madre!
¿Qué pedo?
¡Oh, la verga!
¡No,
oye, aquí! Abrieron así y
luego... ¿Esa bola es putazo o no? ¿Esa te quedó?
¿Está bola?
¿Es hueso?
¿Este es hueso?
I became good friends with one skater. And I told this skater, hey, take me to your friends. Take me to what you know. Let's travel the area. Let's go beyond Rocky Point and travel the whole state and see if there's more out there.
Que en Nogales había muchos patinadores, cientos de patinadores, pero como no hay apoyo, no hay tiendas, no hay skate shops, no hay marcas, pues murió. La gente creció, unos siguieron estudiando, trabajando, unos son licenciados, ingenieros, X cosa, y otros pues trabajan en lo que se puede, ¿no? Ya sea una llantera, o eléctrico, electricista, lo que sea.
Pero estaba bien en corto, ¿no? Acá, en corto.
¿Sí se trabó?
Sí, lo derrumbaron, pero ya tiene mucho tiempo.
Empecé a patinar como desde los 17 años. En ese tiempo no había tantos skateboarders ni nada. Ahora es cuando más se ha visto. Ahora es más unido, sí, como que ya todos... Antes nomás patinaba cada quien con su grupo y eso. Y ahora ya todos pues nos juntamos. Me imagino, no sé si es por la falta de lugares, si es una cosa mala o buena. De que como no, no hay muchos lugares y todos nos concentramos en un solo lugar y ya pues tarde o temprano terminamos siendo amigos y patinando juntos. Alexis es el más aventado, es el que patina mejor, pues todos lo conocen.
Él, no sé, tiene... Es explosivo.
Bueno, pues aquí estamos en la casa, y pues aquí... La cocina, me gusta cocinar, hacer caldos, comida, de todo. Aquí este pues es el cuartito donde trabajo. Esto es el chile que vendo, este. Chile picoso, chile habanero. Este lo muelo aquí en el molino. Sale así. He hecho polvo. Y este lo vendo ahí en la gente, en la calle, en las tiendas. Pues está. Y pues acá arriba, aquí tengo el altar, la Virgen, Guadalupe, la que me cuida. Si me pongo a brincar la cuerda, en la rutina. Ya no me siento como pro, pero sí me gustaría ser. Un pro, a darle a gusto, que está buena la adrenalina que se siente y en chilo los golpes también.
El caso de Alexis, que es una persona muy buena para el skateboarding, más sin embargo pienso que aquí no se le prestan las oportunidades para desarrollar al máximo la capacidad esa que tiene, esa chispa, esa creatividad que tiene en el skateboarding. Aquí no tiene las oportunidades que tendría, ya sea en Estados Unidos o en el sur de México. Amame, amame ahora,
hoy ya no hay más. Estos dulces son dulces artesanales del estado de Michoacán. Bueno, este es un negocio familiar. Mi familia los elabora y me los manda por acá. Yo acá los vendo. Yo salgo a vender lo que son tiendas. I have too many candies. Pues esto es básicamente pues, con lo que yo empecé. Después le brinqué con las patinetas.
Pues no hay tiendas aquí en Nogales. Prácticamente pues yo soy el que le surte a algunos de los patinadores nogalenses, lo que son las tablas. Y pues estamos empezando a traer llantas, tablas, lijas. Poco a poco va creciendo el negocio, ¿no?
Está revolucionando tanto el patinaje aquí en México que ahora un niño ya no quiere un balón de fútbol, ¿no? Que es el deporte número uno aquí en México. Ahora un niño quiere una patineta, ¿no? Entonces es algo padre que está evolucionando.
Soy abuelo y tengo nietos que les gusta muchísimo la cuestión de las patinetas y lógicamente que aquí tenemos, en el parque tenemos unos lugares donde se puede jugar, no tan grandiosos como en Estados Unidos, pero sí suficientemente para practicar ese deporte.
necesitamos apoyo como para otra vez hacerlo otra vez, pues aquí el problema que hay es pues el cerro ese, las piedritas, se nos atoran la llanta y bueno, caemos, nos lastimamos y por eso los morros no les gusta venir mucho aquí. Se fija más bicicletero porque no se le atoran mucho las piedritas. Pues que no esté el hoyo este que nomás hace puro espacio, barca. Para desecharle, para alimentarle, pues que nos ayude nomás con eso, la rampa y ya con lo demás. Como sea, así como lo hicieron, pues. Pero no, nadie viene y nos ayuda. Lo mismo hacemos nosotros, nuestras cosas. Sí, es nuestro parque. Porque dicen que gastaron como un millón y feria en esto y pues no está de creíble que se gaste tanto dinero en este parque. Y pues así, nomás que nos vengan y nos apoyen con eso. O ya de perdida pues las luces o algo así, que se vea movimiento.
Sí se les ha dado apoyo, no lo suficiente, porque no hay el dinero suficiente en nuestra ciudad para apoyar a todos los deportes. México no es un país de primer mundo, donde el dinero abunda.
Aquí puedes ver varias canchas de fútbol, soccer, y más que un solo parque y no muy bien hecho de patineta. Y aquí en Nogales, pues, es el Instituto del Deporte y se dedica de eso, nomás a apoyar a los deportistas. De hecho, no sabían ni que existíamos hasta hace poco que formamos la liga y eso, ya para tener voz en el Instituto del Deporte y ya pedir ayuda más organizado.
Acabamos de formar la primer liga de skaters aquí en Nogales y pues creo que pues vamos bien, ¿no? Por ese lado vamos impulsando poco a poco lo que es el skate y más que nada que el gobierno vea que más que un deporte es un estilo de vida, ¿no?
Simplemente el Instituto del Deporte dijo, ok, si quieren que nos apoyemos en la patineta, organícense y después hacen un proyecto y vemos cómo nos apoyamos. La neta, no hemos recibido apoyo. Entonces, esto es iniciativa propia.
Gracias a todos por venir. Nos lo hemos pasado bien. Qué bueno que nos juntamos todos. Pues qué bueno que nos estemos organizando. Y hay que hacer eventos juntos, así más acoplados todos.
As I was saying, I started researching not just in Rocky Point, but in the region of what's out there. And when I saw that what was needed was to be able to unite that community of skateboarders together, because many towns around here have a strong skateboarding communities within their towns, but there wasn't anything to bring them together. And my idea of bringing them together was to do a regional event.
Y la raza ya llegó, siempre existe la emoción.
Ya se sabe que aquí es fiesta.
La cerveza ya llegó, bien helada creo yo.
No importa, ya la estoy tomando.
And I'm very excited that this year is going to be the fifth year that I do it. I hope everybody attends it. There's a lot of support every year, especially now the significant biggest support is that even the city is really supporting this, and that's a really important aspect about something like that is that finally even the city is buying into what this is about.
Para comenzar, vamos a comenzar con los de intermedio, ya saben. Vamos a hacer grupos de cuatro. Cuando llamemos tu nombre, por favor, pónganse aquí en el cajón del medio, en el combo, ustedes cuatro, para que los jueces sepan quién son. Y van a tener aproximadamente 2 minutos para darle.
Guys, show the judges what you have. Show the secret what you got. Tercer lugar, el señor Ramito Alexis Soporte, Alexis, Lima. Un gran aplauso para Alexis, el hermano de la hermana de los pasados. La solo 15 años del Aldo Reyes, segundo lugar. Agarra su tablita, su trofeo en segundo lugar. ¡Agarra abajo!
And I think it was either the third or fourth year that a gentleman came up and, you know, said, hey, this is cool, what is this? And this person said they were interested in helping.
Uncle Skate was started by Dean Wagner. He's done well for himself, and he travels quite a bit, and he's always loved skateboarding. So he started bringing skateboards with him and giving them away to local kids. And a friend of his that traveled with him just said, you're kind of like a charity already, why don't you start a charity? And so he started Uncle Skate, and at first it was just about bringing skateboarding to kids in third world countries, and then got hooked up with Braulio and ATMC, and then the main focus got to be about providing a quality skate park for those kids, you know, a place that they could learn, that they could grow, something they could be proud of, and then the discussion started to happen with the city.
They were all for it, and they gave us a piece of land, but that lasted like 2 years, and then the administration left. And so I started again with this new administration, and they've been all for it too. But it's been a slow process, and it's just been continuous pressuring and follow through to try to get something done.
Yo soy director de Acción Cívica y Cultural. Veo también lo del skateboard como cultura, es como cultura de patinar. Lo tenemos ya bien claro. Sí es muy difícil patinar aquí en Puerto Peñasco, por eso todos se concentran en el área de Malecón, Plaza Gobernadores, pero no tienen más opciones. Entonces, es muy necesario tener un skate park.
This is a bigger picture of what the skate park here is proposed to look like. We're literally a block and a half from the beach, so it's prime real estate. So it's gonna be perfect. And as you see, there's writing on it. Now these are the kids putting their own 10 cents. It's like, I think it's gonna be the biggest skate park in this whole region.
Sí, claro.
No, sí. Bye. It sounds like maybe the mayor is a little like, so what is this about? Because, you know, he doesn't want to be. And he's like, no, it's just about the skate park and the phenomenon of kids skating everywhere around Rocky Point, stuff like that. So that's what it is.
If you build a big enough quality park, you could start to get large international contests there, that it could be like the next Bondi Bowl or something like that, that if it was good enough, we could get this to happen.
There's a lot of handshaking and a lot of head nodding and a lot of yeses, but nothing in writing that is going to be built. I think this is the closest we've ever been to getting a skate park done, and I feel confident that it can happen.
Pues es más fácil practicar, es más fácil avanzar. Y está más a gusto porque de ahí no te corren ni te dicen nada, porque pues es de los patinadores, pues, ¿sí me entiendes? Y pues le están poniendo muchas más ganas que los años pasados. A lo mejor sí se va a hacer.
Gustavo, we started giving stuff to a few years ago, and then we went did a tour through Texas, and he met us in El Paso and got to meet the team and hang out and skate with the team. It's cool. He's super motivated and works really hard. You know, sends us a video like every month, and you know, he's very self-motivated in the sense of he's going to do it regardless of, you know, what we're doing or what anybody's doing. So Gustavo represents our brand well, and you know. En México.
Mi caja de Nike se acaba de llegar. Vamos arriba.
A los 7 años conoció la primera tabla. Le compré una tabla y empezó a...
Hicieron un skateboard allá en Delicias.
Entonces sí, ya cuando lo terminaron, era a diario su disciplina.
Siempre desde chiquito él, cuando agarraba su patineta y se iba a tocar a la casa de los amiguitos a ver quién quería patinar con él, y sentados así alrededor de la mesa estábamos comiendo todos. Y él tendría como 11 años y él se levantó de la mesa y me encantó porque él dijo, mamá, a mí nadie me va a alejar de mis sueños.
A mí me dijo como a los 11, 12 años, pa, yo voy a ser pro, yo voy a ser profesional.
Ah, Gustavo lo empecé a ver cuando lo llevaba su papá de Delicias al skatepark de Chihuahua. Lo vi desde bien chavito acá. Me acuerdo que en un concurso hay un patinador acá bien famoso así en la escena local. Pues traía el primer lugar y todo. Me acuerdo que Gustavo le dio una chinga.
Que el gobierno te escuchara y pusiera acá parquecitos en las colonias. Mini ramps, handrails de repente. Entonces, pues ya de perdida ya tienes un lugar a donde ir cerca y no irte a perder a buscar el skate, porque sabes como, pues si es muy lejos, esto está suave.
These two kids have matured so much. These two kids have gotten so much better in skateboarding. And it is amazing when you guys see the difference from just a year ago to now. These are totally different kids. They're a lot better than they used to be. So I think one of my proudest moments with Aldo and that I started seeing that change was when he was accepted into being a competitor for the Phoenix Am. Even though we've been working hard to get something going on for the community here in Rocky Point, we also have that other aspect of what we're trying to do for Aldo and Christian, and that is trying to get him more experiences and market them a little bit better. Part of the plan also for me was sponsorship and a way that I was starting to construct that bridge that so I can, you know, get rid of that gap was I need to have kids here sponsored by the U.S. I started taking them to the U.S. to trips and competitions and letting them know, hey, this is a skater from Rocky Point. Really? People skate in Rocky Point? What's that about? And I started gaining an interest. And they're like, dang, he's a really good skater. Really? Is there a skate park in Rocky Point? Not really.
I live in Redwood.
Oh, it's cold.
Yeah, no. They don't even open this anymore.
This is Metro 1. Yeah, but we hop in this.
There's hundreds of spots. That's the beauty about being here, you know? This is like the holy grail. Having this provides you with the comfort zone and the, you know, the perfect energy to create from. Everyone deserves a chance to create.
We're pretty much at the same spot when we last saw you. Last thing I did was send him our point of contact for the city of Rocky Point, a Facebook message. That's how we communicate as far as what was the status, if he had spoken with the mayor and had any progress in the skate park. And that message went unanswered. And I tried calling also a few times and the phone calls went unanswered. And that's where we're at. So there hasn't been an answer since. And I noticed that it was read right away. So I figured, well, okay, they read it and they're gonna go look into it, but no. So I just sent him another text or inbox and hopefully they'll answer, but that's just how it is. I remember speaking that maybe if we didn't get to some type of progress by now, that it was gonna start looking unlikely that a skate park would ever be built. I was aware that there was a scene in Mexico City. And I learned that there was a huge difference, that there is a lot more support, that there are already brands over there in Mexico. The big name brands like, you know, Nike and all the big brand name shoes and clothing and so forth and so on. Monster Energy. They have invested a lot in Mexico City.
My skate career, I only went to Mexico one time. You know, my father and all my aunts and uncles on his side were all born there. I did a demo there 2 summers ago, and it was mayhem. By far, the most intense experience I've ever had as far as, like, you know, being a skater. And that's when it hit me, like, how big skateboarding was there.
México está viviendo la escena más importante de en el skate en México. Para la construcción de este skatepark, Nike puso el 100% del presupuesto de construcción y la delegación Álvaro Obregón, en conjunto con el gobierno nuestro federal, donaron el espacio.
Vaya la lira, güey. Es que la lira.
¿Qué te había dicho?
Empecé a patinar en el 88, en 1988. El skateboarding en México en el 88 éramos muy pocos. Éramos como los chicos raros, ¿no? Era super underground. Éramos the weirdos, porque en ese tiempo pues, era Bones Brigade, ¿no? Anime Chin. Ese fue mi primer video que yo vi. Yo empecé a patinar por Bones Brigade. Para mí es uno de los mejores teams en la historia. And then I go with my mom and say, you know what, mom, I want to skate. And I always be a hiperactive kid. Siempre fui hiperactivo. Y the only way to control me with my mom was with the skateboarding. So for my mom was like the perfect tool for control me. Oh, you want to skate? You need to go to school. You wanna skate, you need to eat, you know? Like, I always like tick, 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 tick. So for me, technically, like, skateboarding saved my life. No, terminó el skateboarding, por la economía en México se vino abajo y todo el mundo desapareció. Desaparecieron los skate shops, no more skate parks. Un skateboard de costarte $100 te costaba $300, you know? O sea, todo fue como doble. Y patinábamos por patinar. Realmente no había una industria en México. Apenas ahora empezó una industria. Que aún así la industria en México lleva 20 años de atraso, ¿no? Hay mucha gente, hay mucho talento, hay mucho mercado, hay mucho que hacer, es un mercado virgen y es una industria virgen. Yo siento que hace falta esa fusión entre Estados Unidos y México. Si estamos totalmente como pegados, ¿no? Somos vecinos.
Is to have this skate park built by Mexicans but supervised by an established American company that knows exactly how to make a skate park. So finally they gave us a budget of $30,000. So then we got together with an engineer out of Phoenix. His name is Morgan Ellig.
Building a skate park isn't just throwing a bone to the local skateboarding kids. It gives them a good place to stay off the street and hone their skills, and some of them can probably make a good livelihood eventually out of this.
And we got together with them and they built the blueprints and everything, did a great job in staying within the parameters. And we met with the city, they approved it, and finally we gave it to the city and they started working on it. We gave the blueprints to the city. Wow. For whatever reason, they weren't able to supervise the whole project. And so once the supervision stopped, the city started losing track on following correctly the schematics. And finally it got to the point where the kids started sending me pictures of areas that weren't even skatable that the city was building. And once I brought this up to the attention of the city, they told me that they never had the blueprints. And so I had to prove to them that I did give them the blueprints, but apparently the person I gave it to didn't give it to the other person.
This one and those two were made unsupervised.
It's sketchy because, yeah, it's not gonna last, but those ones look good. You know, they're real tight. They didn't make the transition all the way to the bottom, but it's semi-skatable. This thing's good. The middle main, like, little pyramid thing here.
These three pieces were supervised.
Oh, okay.
Everything else wasn't.
I like that they're already starting to DIY it, though, and bringing in, like, the curvy flat bar. That part's good.
It was a breakdown in communication between the city and the contractor and Uncle Skate and ATMC, and it just, the pieces didn't fall together correctly, and we were all a little bummed about it.
Realmente la mitad del parque, como vemos, no se puede patinar, pero pues de perdida se hizo algo y pues estamos muy agradecidos.
La rampa del medio, esa rampa nunca nadie la va a usar, no sirve para nada. ¿Sí?
It's supposed to be a ledge cover. You can't even like.
Okay, mira, tenemos un chingo de producto que quiere decir mucho producto. Y vamos a hacer para todos un mejor truco. Voy a poner al Cristian y al Aldo. Ellos van a estar escogiendo quién se lo está rifando y todo. Vamos a durar 20 minutos para el mejor truco en ese spot. Eso, y después de los 20 minutos ya va a ser un skate sesh y vamos a comenzar a dar producto a todo el mundo.
¡Ánimo!
Good stuff. We're good. We're done. Yeah, we're done!
The U.S. and Mexico want to come together. They really want it. What has really made things happen has been the partnerships that I've been able to establish with people and companies and organizations to be able to really make that impact and difference in the community. Part of your documentary was to kind of go around the different parts of Mexico and figure things out. And one thing led to another, how we started talking about Levi's and learning that Levi's does a skate park throughout the world, and they go find places where a skate park is needed. And so I started showing people that you have these couple kids from a small town in Rocky Point that are kind of going up there in the US and kicking some butt. Now, they are officially recognized in the United States that there's these two Mexican kids sponsored in the US, and I think that was so important to now be able to use that as a tool to say, there's more of that. Come over here, I'll show you. And there's organizations now like Levi's that has come in and sees what's going on, and they're like, that's what we're about, Raulio from ATMC. And then let's do something together. And I'm like, let's do it.
Detrás de ti.
They're sick. Yeah, they're cool. They were with us in Phoenix. They were shredding out there. They even came to, we skated like a vert ramp, backyard vert ramp, and they were getting on there and ripping it up. No, they're cool. They're good kids. Shredders, you know, they got heart. If you got heart, you know, you can make it happen.
No, 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 no.
Originally, the plan was that the skate park was already gonna be 80% done by the time, you know, Levi's got here, so they can film that progress. But that hasn't happened. They don't get too hyped up about certain things because it hurts every time you get let down. It's not gonna be until they see the skate park built that then they're gonna be celebrating, rejoicing, and all that.
Hey Jade, are you still at the park? Okay, so a small congregation of the two people that are gonna represent the mayor, they're going down there to speak with you and us. So this is kind of like the little moment of truth, so stand by. I guess they're really intense in their talk. So I guess we'll wait for them, I bet. At first they were like, no, come over, but it looks like maybe they're doing a pre-talk, yeah. Braulio, un placer. Aquí les presento al representante de Levi's. Eric, también de Levi's, de la producción.
El problema, ¿no?
I'll try to interpret. So.
Bueno, el terreno original, por llamarlo de una forma, ¿no? Ese terreno no tiene certeza jurídica todavía, pues. O sea, tiene broncas legales.
A la par de este tema, estuvimos platicando con Fausto y estuvimos viendo opciones. ¿Sabes qué, Fausto? Dime dónde más quieres y el encuentro lo puedo conseguir. Vimos partes turísticas por parte de Las Conchas, aquí mismo, aquí enseguida, y otras partes. Hay que terminar un juicio testamentario, por decirlo de cierta manera. Nos va a llevar un par de meses todavía apurando el tema.
Ok, para explicarle todo eso va a estar de ser, sí. ¿Verdad? Canijo decir. ¿Se los puedo comentar en forma privada rápido nomás?
Sí, sí. Para.
Ok. As always, complications. I said that you guys can also do. What they're saying, they don't want to lose this opportunity, but they want to give you guys the choice, and that choice is, if your heart's set in that location, then they're gonna work that, and they're gonna make sure it goes through, but it's gonna take about 2 months. I think the whole 2 month thing is that, let's say, you guys choose to put it in a different location, it's gonna take probably the same amount of time, right, to just come all start all over again with the new design.
Well,
and all
that stuff. What are the concerns with 2 months being 4 months or 2 months not happening too? Like, do you have concerns?
It's not a 100%.
Yeah.
And so my suggestion is to pressure them to keep it where we're at. That's my suggestion.
Sí, dice que está fuera de las manos de ellos. Si tratan de cambiar, no, ya no tienen dinero, presupuesto, nada para cambiarlo a otro lugar y va a ser costo, y si no es aquí.
Se van. Se pierde todo.
Se pierde. Y si hay cambio, ya es presupuesto que ya no tienen. Lo que tienen, ya tienen. Y ahí ya estamos.
Tiene que ser allá.
Si corremos el riesgo de no hacerlo allá,
se va
a acabar.
Bueno, yo me encargo que sea allá. Está bien. Yo voy a negociar con las partes para.
Está bien.
Pues ahorita ya me pongo a negociar ese tema yo.
Ok.
Sí. Y tenga la tranquilidad. Va a ser ahí.
Ok, vamos entonces a decírselo
sí,
a ellos.
Ok.
Gracias. Bien. Gracias, tesorero. Muchas gracias.
Pues pienso que el parque se va a construir porque la comunidad está viendo que el skateboarding en México está creciendo y se está viendo un apoyo muy grande de lo que es Levi's, la ITMC. Y pues me siento muy bien porque va a haber muchas oportunidades para que los jóvenes patinadores crezcan en este deporte y se vean más motivados, traten de hacer algo con skate.
You know, the reason why skateboarders are strong people is because what they do is they fall and they get back up. It's your job to overcome all those temporary setbacks, because that's how they are. They're always going to be temporary. All the no's are always going to be temporary. And so you have to continue, because it's going to happen.
Que brinque frontera, que cruce mi ropa la libertad. No hay drama ni tempestad, y si hay la voy a enfrentar. Son las cicatrices de los días grises.
Of course it can be done in Mexico. It just takes the grit. If your motivation is strong enough, that'll lead you to figure it out. That'll lead you to investigate and find what steps to take.
Mis alas por fin saldrán, y siempre lo dije, lo cumplo bien firme, a mí voy a respaldar. Ya lo tengo bien decidido, dejar lo viejo en el olvido, eso me queda prohibido. Yo ya me despido de ese enemigo, mirar atrás solo me cansa. Adiós pasar en tu venganza, ahora puesto en la balanza, siento que ya vas a ganar esta batalla. El cielo abre y yo sigo el vuelo, el fuego quema y yo no le temo a nada. Ya la tengo ganada. Ya es tarde y voy a alcanzar la luz.
Skateboarding in Mexico be around for so long. So how you can do it? Skateparks and support.
Vida conspirará a tu favor, ya verás. Está de tu lado, no tengas cuidado, es hora de festejar. La magia de ti saldrá, como agua tú fluirás. El mundo que hiciste y así mereciste, el Dharma ha llegado ya. Ya lo tengo bien decidido, dejar lo viejo en el olvido, eso me queda prohibido. Yo ya me despido de ese enemigo, mirar atrás solo me cansa. Adiós pasado y tu venganza, ahora puesto en la balanza, siento que ya avanza, gana esta batalla.
You know, life is exactly, it's not a lot like skateboarding, it's exactly like skateboarding.
Thank you.
ya las velas del pastel. Y aún en mi tabla de X flojos por la calle, y no hay quien calle. Es un desmadre, yo feliz patinando, no me meto con nadie en cambio. Todo el mundo jode, jode con su bla bla bla, con su mugre pseudo crítica constructiva, con su vida toda linda que a mí no me va. Su mundito color rosa, lo superficial. ¿Cuántas veces me he metido contigo? Dime, ¿cuántas veces te he ofendido? Dime, es comportamiento de amigos, que tu vida sea un desmadre y te la cobres conmigo. Basta, me subiré a mi skateboard a olvidarlo todo, a rolar por ahí, a borrar tu odio. Los que no creen en mí, no soy moneda de oro, y los que siguen aquí son mi gran tesoro.